Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let us now spend a few times in worship.
Together, glorify the Lord. is a joy to be in the presence of God once again. We look at the situation across the country. The lockdown is taking us through a different kind of a stage. We have been completely locked down, but we don't want this situation to continue. I would like to encourage that we pray seriously about how God could intervene and help us come out of this situation. I would like to read a verse before we start into the Word of God, which says in 1 Samuel chapter 12, verses 23 says, "As for me, far be it from me that I should sin against the Lord by failing to pray for you, and I will teach you the way that is good and right." We see Samuel, although he disagreed with the Israelites in many ways, because when they asked for a king, he was concerned, but he assured that the Israelites that he would continue to pray for them. We may disagree with others, but we shouldn't stop praying for them. So this day, I would like to talk to you about three personalities which in the scripture, who had the zealousness. I want to talk about zealousness, which is the eagerness, the burden, the dedication, the enthusiasm, the great devotion these people had during the situation that they were in. I would like to draw our attention to the book of Numbers, chapter 25, verses 1 through 13. I would just read this out, and then I would like to talk on this verse. Numbers 25, verses 1 to 13. "While the Israelites were camped at Acacia Grove, some of the men defiled themselves by having sexual relations with the local Moabite. These women invited them to attend sacrifices to their gods, so the Israelites feasted with them and worshipped the gods of Moab. In this way, Israel joined in the worship of Baal of Peor, causing the Lord's anger to blaze against his people. The Lord issued the following command to Moses: seize all the ringleaders, execute them before the Lord in broad daylight, so his fierce anger will turn away from the people. So Moses ordered the Israel judges, each one of you must put to death the men under your authority who have joined in the worship of Baal Peor. Just then, one of the Israelite men brought a Midianite woman into his tent right before the eyes of Moses and all the people, as everyone was weeping at the entrance of the tabernacle. When Phinehas, son of Eleazar and grandson of Aaron the priest, saw this, he jumped up and left the assembly. He took a spear and rushed after the man into his tent. Phinehas thrust the spear all the way through the man's body and into the woman's stomach, so the plague against the Israelites was stopped. But not before 24,000 people had died. The Lord said to Moses, 'Phinehas, son of Eleazar, and grandson of Aaron, the priest, has turned my anger away from the Israelites by being zealous among them as I was. So I stopped destroying all the Israelites, as I intended to do in my zealous anger. Now tell him that I am making him special covenant of peace with him. In this covenant, I give him and his descendants a permanent right to the priesthood for his zeal for me, his God. He purified the people of Israel, making them right with me." We look at this chapter here. We see the zealousness of Phinehas. He raised to the occasion, and he intervened, and he made the plague to cease. Not before the 24,000 people died. And here's what the Lord says about him. He says that Phinehas, son of Eleazar and grandson of Aaron the priest, has turned my anger away from the Israelites. by being zealous among them as I was. Today we see there's zealousness. I mean, the zealousness is what is needed to stand in that gap, to raise to an occasion. We see the situation around us and we need to raise to this occasion. And we need to pray seriously. This is what I wanted to bring to our attention. We have another 8 days. I think 8 days we have for the lockdown to come to an end. But we don't know the situation. But we need to pray like never before, asking God to help us to come out of this situation so that the life will come back to normalcy. We see Jesus as our forerunner. When we read Psalm 69:9, it says, it goes like this: passion for your house has consumed me, and the insults of those who insult you have fallen on me. We see here a prayer of desperation of David. Although this was referred to Jesus, the disciples remembered this when they saw Jesus driving away the people who were defiling the temple of God. So we see the zealousness, our forerunner was Jesus. We need to have that zealousness that at this point of time, in this kind of a situation, how are we dealing with the situation? Are we serious in our prayers? Gospel of John, chapter 2, verses 17 says, then his disciples remembered that it was written, zeal for your house has eaten me up. So we see here that the zealousness of God, Jesus himself is a forerunner, and he has shown us a path. We are his dwelling place, and he will not allow us to perish. So we need to have that zealousness and call upon the Lord and seek his face and favor, so that there will be a deliverance. There would be an end to this situation, and we will come back to normalcy. We see here during the time of Jesus' days, in the book of Hebrews, chapter 5, verses 7, it reads like this: During the days of Jesus' life on earth, he offered up prayers and petitions with fervent cries and tears to the one who called, one who could save him from the death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission, fear, devotion, and zeal. So today we see that Jesus is our forerunner. During a kind of a situation, how did he submit himself to the Lord? How he was devoted to the Lord? How he submitted his life to the Lord, his prayer life? I would like to also draw your attention of Prophet Daniel. Here we see the Prophet Daniel and his zeal. When the desolation of Jerusalem was what would last for 17 years. That's what it says. Let me read the book of from the book of Daniel, chapter 9, verses 1 to 4. I would like to read so that we could meditate on that. It says, it was the first year of the reign of Darius, the Mede, the son of Ahasuerus, who became the king of Babylonians. During the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, learned from reading the word of the Lord, has revealed to Jeremiah, the prophet, that Jerusalem must lie desolate for 70 years. See, he gets the attention of the 70 years captivity of the Israelites. And what does he do? He quickly acts on those situation. And we learn that through Daniel's prayer, zeal and enthusiasm, that prayer cannot be overemphasized. We ought to take it seriously. See, we learn from him that we need to take prayer seriously. When we pray seriously, God will make a way and open the doors and help us see the greater things. So we see here, how did he respond? See, he responded by praying and calling upon the situation. And he came to know that it had come to an end, the desolation. So I turned to the Lord and pleaded with him in prayer and fasting. I also wore rough burlap and sprinkled myself with ashes. I prayed to the Lord my God and confessed. See, we see in the life of Daniel, he saw the situation and he rose to the occasion and he prayed zealously, asking God to bring about a change. As we pray, let us also remember the psalmist's words, "The Lord is on my side, I will not fear." So Prophet Daniel pleaded with God to bring about the promised return of his people to their land. The prophet Jeremiah had written that God would not allow the captives to return to their land for 70 years. Daniel knew this prophecy and realized that 70-year period was coming to an end, and he prayed. So today, my friends, I would like to encourage you to pray seriously. We are going to have the next 8 days of this lockdown. But we don't know. But it all depends on how we are going to submit our life in prayer. When we pray zealously, without fear, without looking back, without ceasing. We see how Jacob had wrestled with the Lord throughout the day. And he said, "Until you bless me, I shall not leave thee." So let us, in these last few days, let us pray like never before so that God will bring about a greater change. And we see another, how God replied to Daniel, the prophet. In verses 9, chapter 9, verse 23, it says, "As soon as you began to pray, an answer was given, which I have to tell you, for you are highly esteemed, therefore consider this." So you see a prayer which is being answered. Let us be zealous to remain in faith. Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. In the book of Jude, chapter 1, verses 3 says, "Dear friends, I had not been eagerly planning to write to you about the salvation we all share, but I find that I must write about something else, urging you to defend your faith." So in the last days, we need to remain in faith so that we may be able to overcome this this situation. Then there's another thing also I would like to say before I close. In Romans chapter 10 verses 1 says that we need to be zealous for salvation for others. Other people, God doesn't want other people to perish. Dear brothers and sisters, that's what it says. "Dear brothers and sisters, the longing of my heart and my prayer to God is for the people of Israel to be saved." In Titus, another book, it says, chapter 2 verses 14 says, "Let us be zealous, totally committed in doing good works." In these last days, let us remain in faith and remember the people who had the zealousness and bringing an end to the situation that they were in. And today when we pray like never before, God is definitely going to bring about a great change in our country and the whole world. Merciful Father, gracious Lord, we thank you for this time, Lord Father. We give you all the glory and all the praise. Father, Lord, help us to be zealous like Phineas, like Daniel, Lord, to raise to the occasion and pray. Lord, you have been our forerunner, Lord Father, teaching us, Lord, how you live a life of prayer and bringing about a great change, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Father, we thank you, Lord. Help us, Lord, as believers, as individuals, as ministers in your vineyard, O Father God, that we pray and intercede, Lord, that you will bring about a great change in our present situation, Lord, so that we may glorify and give a testimony, Lord Jesus, that our Lord is a prayer-answering God. We give you all the glory and all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen.